can imagine. You have to carry a diaper bag and all that stuff.
Yeah, I've been through all that. Speed's only in the second, third chapter.
I composition at Washington and Lee University in Lexington, Virginia. And Terry's really the inspiration for the word eclectic on tonight's program. He's here to hear his own piano quartet for the first time. But the last time he was here at the University of Oregon, he conducted the UO Jazz Band in his own arrangements of Stephen Sondheim. And here's a gentleman who played bass in the Glenn Miller Band that's also being commissioned by the Cleveland Orchestra. So he's one of the most versatile and knowledgeable musicians I've ever met, and it's great to have him back. Also appearing on tonight's program is Jasper Wood, professor of violin at the University of British Columbia. And Jasper and I have been, we've been performing together for 30 years now, since 1993, and I think we've probably played 300-400 recitals together, I've never really counted. But it's been a long time, and it's always a great pleasure to get Jasper back here to the University of Oregon. So, first piece on the program is the great Prokofiev Sonata for two violins with Jasper Wood and UO's very own, the illustrious Professor Hal Grossman. And without further ado, I hope you enjoy the show.
Thank you.
when it comes to that significance of an expression.
Thank you. Thank you. Composer of the next piece that you're going to hear. I'll tell you about a little bit about that in a second, but first I just want to thank Professor Riley and University of Oregon School of Music for inviting me once again. Such a great place. I always have fun here. We always make such great music, so I appreciate being back here. This piece was written on a train. If you ever have the chance, as I did, to take an Amtrak train across this country, it's pretty marvelous, and I did that with the sole purpose of writing this piece. So I left from a train station in Virginia, about six blocks from my house in a little town of Stanton, Virginia, took a train to Chicago, took the train from Chicago just below the Canadian border all the way to Portland, Oregon, spent a couple of days relaxing there, got on a train heading south, stopped at the Eugene train station here for what they call a fresh air break along the way before heading down to Sacramento and then taking the train all the way across through Salt Lake City and the Colorado Rockies back to Chicago and back home. About 9 days in total of living in a roomette and sitting there with my music sketch pad, either in the observation car or in my roomette writing this piece of music, inspired by the motion of the train and so much of the train. If you haven't done something like this, I recommend it. All your meals are provided in a nice, elegant dining car. I was traveling alone, and so I always had meals with three strangers. So it's a great way to meet people who are doing the same things you're doing. The piece, you will hear some things in this piece that you will directly maybe remind you of train travel. The clanking of the cars, you'll hear at the very end, sort of like the steam sort of escaping from the brakes. You'll hear some tidbits of the elegance of this experience, something like out of the old world that was so beautiful and relaxing. You'll hear that perpetual motion that you kind of get used to over and over. The title, Parallel Tracks, obviously relates to the two tracks of the railroad that always, from one end to the other, are there like parallel lines that never touch one another. But there's also a theme going through this composition about the parallel tracks in life that are not so equally divided and never meet. They overlap, they cross over. And in my writing this, you'll hear the strings in the piano serving as separate tracks that at times seem to be almost at two different tempos from one another, and then they come together and they bounce ideas back and forth going down these tracks before ending up at the end of the ride all simultaneously, leaving you hopefully comfortably in your home station. So I'm real excited. I'm the only composer that could be here tonight on this program, so I speak for all of them. Just thank you for being here. Thank you for supporting this kind of music. And I hope you enjoy this new piece of mine. If you have any questions afterwards, feel free to come up and chat. So I'm going to sit down in the audience and enjoy these great musicians with you. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.